So the time that I was making moves and I was making bad mistakes in my life, God wasn't being acknowledged.
Yes, sir.
And so he allowed me to just continue on making my own moves. And I thought sometimes in the game of checkers you'd be doing pretty good until you find out somebody say crown me. When your opponent say crown me. And once they get that king, they can move all over the board. And they can jump you and jump over you 2 or 3 times.
That's all right, pal.
You find yourself being jumped over and left out of a whole lot of things. If you would have waited.
That's all right.
And so I continued on, you know, playing the game of checkers in my life, and I could never see the direction of God. Because I was doing my will and not his will. I was making my moves and not God, the moves that God had for me to make.
Amen.
And I looked and I kept on thinking about the elder, and I looked at David's life. When David got ready to go out to war, David asked God, he would consider God and said, God, can I go?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
God would tell him, go.
Go.
And God would give him instructions how to handle his business on the field. And he would be blessed because he listened to God. But so many times in my life, I don't know about you, but so many times in my life, I never asked God, can I go? And my life became a mess because I didn't know how to acknowledge God. David went out to war and he won the battle. Comes back in, Saul was on his trail, and David still asked God, can I go? God gave him permission to go, and he won that one. And God gave him permission to go again, and he won that. Every time he acknowledged God and God told him to go, God told him that he would win the battle. But God got angry with Saul with David one time. Because he made a move without concerning
him.
How many times when you look back over your life, if you would just consider God? And say, Lord, if you want me to go, I'll go. But I got to consider you. I got to consult you and make sure everything is going to be all right.
That's all right, pal.
God got angry with David. Why? I'm glad you asked, because he censored the people. God didn't tell him to do that, but he did it anyway. Not only was David punished, but the people of God were punished too, because David did something, made a move that he shouldn't have made.
That's right.
And I look back over my life many a time, and I said, Lord, I shouldn't have made that move. I should have made, if I would have done this way, I would have been alright, I would have been better, I would have been further along in my life. Yeah. But I made the wrong move. But now that I receive Christ in my life. Let me back up. When David began to write these songs, David was in a world of trouble. God had pulled him out, but he was in trouble.
Yeah.
And he began to write these words. He began to look over his life and write these words. He says, teach me. What is wrong with the church? The church don't want to be taught anymore. By the Lord. He said, teach me.
Jesus.
Oh Lord, and lead me into a
right path.
You know, when you get yourself together, you can say those words, but as long as you out, you're willing to do your own will and make your own mistake. And I call them growing pains, because we all have been through some growing pains. And you look back over your life and you say, Lord, if I wouldn't have stopped when somebody told me to stop. If I would have listened to what my parents told me, I wouldn't be going through the trouble that I'm going through right now. But you find yourself having to deal with problems, and if you would have only listened.
Thank you, God.
Grandmama and them used to say that a hard head.
Yes, sir.
An come and clean it up.
Yeah, soft. Yeah.
We'll make a soft.
Yeah.
Come on, preacher. Take it where you want to take it.
You know what you're talking about.
We'll make a soft behind it.
Mm-hmm.
You see, when your head is hard,
mm-hmm.
you won't listen to nobody, and you want to do it your way. And when you find out in the end, your way is not the right way, and your butt get a little soft then. Because you would say, only if I would have listened to what they told me, I wouldn't be going through life.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
All right,
but because sir, I had to have it my way.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's all right.
And sometimes one mistake will cost you for the rest of your life. It will take you a lifetime to get out of. And you have to look back and say, if I would have just corrected myself 20 years ago.
Go ahead.
That's all right, Pastor.
It's all right.
I got myself a story that it took me almost a lifetime to get out of.
What's
up?
What's up?
Follow.
Jesus. What's up?
Praise God.
Amen.
Glory.
I don't know why it took me so long. I just couldn't get rid of it.
Glory. Preach up.
Yeah.
That's all.
Come on, preach up.
This thing had got all in my bones and I couldn't get rid of it.
Glory. What's up?
Oh, but one day.
Hey. Talk, sir. Talk, sir.
I met somebody.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I come to tell you who I met this morning.
Yeah. Hallelujah. It's all right.
I met somebody that told me to consider my way.
Yes, sir. Come on, fix it up.
Now when I'm getting ready to make a move, I don't care what it is.
Go ahead,
Pastor.
Jesus.
Somebody say, you want that? I know I want it, but I got to consider, I got to talk to God about
yes,
it, and he got to assure me
yes,
that's what he wants in my life.
That's right.
Yes,
that's right.
Amen. Amen.
That's right.
Word about
my Lord. Before I make a move on this checkerboard, I can look at the board and I can say, well, I can give up this thing.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
In order to get where I need to be.
Uh-huh.
And I said, and in my mind, I said, I don't have but one move to make.
Right.
And I can get where I need to
yes,
be.
Sir. Yes, sir.
And everything looks good. It looks like God's hand is on me.
Come on, preach up.
Yes, sir. It looks like God's blessing me. It looks like God's saying, yes, yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
Because it looks like a blessing.
Come on, preach up.
But the scripture says every good gift.
Come on,
every
sir.
And I thought it was God.
Yeah, yeah.
I prayed about it.
Come on now.
But I didn't hear God say nothing.
All right.
And I thought it was God still.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So when I made my move, God said, whoa.
Come on now.
All right. My Lord.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. See, God has a time to be in a time to
yes,
do
that. Yes, yes,
and
yes,
wait on the Lord.
Right. Yes. That's all right.
Amen.
That's all right.
Amen. People are constantly moving.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I thank God for some things I've heard. Nobody has told me that God sees.
Amen. Amen.
My Lord.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
My God.
Thank you, God.
And so I find myself now. Seeking God.
Yes.
Talking to God.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is this for me?
Yeah, yes, Lord Jesus.
His hand is all over.
Yeah.
But Lord, it is still for me.
That's right.
I find myself worrying sometimes. Because what he has for me looks so good.
Yeah.
And it looks like that he's just ready to overflow in my life.
Yeah.
I sit still sometimes and wait.
Yeah.
And make sure that this is God.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sometimes the enemy.
Yeah, on, that's right. That's ooh, right, man.
Makes things look so good
that's
to
right.
you.
That's right.
That's right.
I'm gonna go back just a little bit, y'all. I'm gonna go back.
Come on, Pastor. Thank you,
God. Fix it
up. Abraham and Sarah connected. They made the wrong move. God promised them a child. But both of them made the wrong move.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
calling themselves to say that they're going to help God. God don't need your help. When he's going to bless you. If God said that he was going to bless you, you sit there and wait on the Lord. God has it all in control. And so, bro, I'm sitting there playing this game of checkers in my mind. Make one move, I'm okay. Make another move, I'm fine. God is with me. God is with me because I'm doing it. Making the right move. I'm blessed. God is with me. No trouble so far. But just as soon as I make one move, and I found my men dying off on the board. Folks sleeping. On the boat.
Yeah. That's all right.
And I have to step back and check myself out.
That's all right now.
Because the Bible says examine your own self.
Yes,
that's right.
See, make sure that you're right.
That's right.
So I examine myself. What did I do wrong? And I found that I didn't wait long enough. And it caused me to lose some people in my life.
Come on, Pastor.
With a premonition of God. And I got where I needed to be.
Glory.
So when I got where I needed to be, I said, crown me.
It's
my time. See, when you get in the place that God wants you to be, he'll crown you with the anointed oil of God. And then every step that you make, you acknowledge him and God. So, God, can I go over here? Yes. It prospers me. God, can I do this? Yes. It prospers me. God, can I do this? No. Because every answer from God is not yes. Myself in the yes and no of life. I got off the checkboard now. I found myself just in the yes and no of life, in the waiting part of my life. Somebody prophesied that I was going to get a car. Guess what? I'm waiting.
I'm
waiting on God because guess what? I make a move without God.
That's right.
If everything that y'all said that he was going to bless me, first to me. If we learn to wait on God, we'll get what we need.
That's right.
So I'm waiting to watch God do his work. What I learned when God does his work is that you don't bless me. You don't bless me because you'll take the credit for blessing me. And not your personal finances. Why the frick your bread to miss up go by God? Hallelujah. I'm not talking about my credit now. My credit pretty good. I'm just letting you know. But your credit can be so messed up, but God steps in.
That's right.
That car won't move.
Yes, it will.
That house won't move. Until I say so.
That's right.
Until the person I want in.
That's right.
And so we find ourselves. In the yes and no of life, when you come to Christ, when you come to him, you have to sit down and consider yourself. Consider what's God's will.
That's right.
God, what is your will for my life? What move should I make now in my life? I want you to direct my path, God. I want you to show me my ways. Where did I go to do your will?
Today?
I'm acknowledging him in all my ways. See, a good man steps. You see, a bad man steps can go anywhere he wants to go. But when you have the steps of God in order, you just can't do what you want to do. Because God said, go here, you got to go there. God said, go in the piccolo joint. There's somebody I need you to preach to in the piccolo joint. You got to go there. And guess what? You come. You got to stop being ashamed of what God sent us. Just do the will of God.
That's right.
Amen. There's somebody in the house right now. In a bad place in their life right now. And God has told somebody to go see them about it.
My Lord.
Jesus.
My God.
And you're still asking the question, God is the truth. Yes, it's Him.
Yeah.
Hey.
My God.
You really think that the devil will tell you to go check on somebody?
No.
Jesus.
Thank you, God.
David says, I have fainted unless I believe.
Yeah.
You see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Mm-hmm.
Other words, David said, my hope.
Mm-hmm.
If I didn't believe God fully, if I didn't take God at His word, if God didn't tell me what He was going to do in my life, He said, I would have fainted.
Yeah.
He said, but because I believe God.
Yes, Lord.
Because I believe God.
Thank you, God.
Yes, Lord. Jesus.
I would have given up a long time ago, but I believe God.
Yes.
Glory.
I would have lost heart a long time ago, but I believe God.
Yeah. My God.
He said some goodness got to come to me sometime.
Yeah.
That's why He said the wall is. That's why David says
God.
Because he had already had an experience with God.
Yeah.
He had already had an experience with God, and God messed around and put a table.
Yes.
Prepared a feast in front of his table.
Yes,
see, your enemy think that as long as I got you down, God can't do nothing for you.
Yeah.
It'll look bad for you, but God will mess around and set up a table.
Yes, He will.
Thank you, God.
Yes, He
will.
And your enemy will say, I thought you were ready to give up, you were ready to fail. But you do have to remember how good God has been to you.
Yes.
Glory.
I can't make a move now without prayer. Without considering my way.
That's right.
Without talking to God.
That's right.
And like I said, when it gets so strong on me, I have to sit down. And listen. Shut enough listening.
That's right.
Enough.
Yeah, that's right.
Not that I ask the question, is it you? Because the Bible says a stranger. His sheep know His voice.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Amen.
I know His voice.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I know His voice concerning every good gift.
Jesus. Thank You, Lord.
Good and perfect gift.
Thank You, Lord.
That's right.
Yeah. Thank You, Lord.
Thank You, God.
Everything that looks good, y'all. Everything that looks good, everything that looks perfect. It just might not be coming from the Lord.
That's right.
That's why you have to sit down.
Yes, that's the truth.
Wait on God.
Yes.
Sit there and wait on Him.
Yes.
My Lord.
I forgot somebody sung a song. I'm just sitting here waiting.
Waiting on Jesus.
My
Lord. Lord, I'm going to wait.
Yes.
Until my waiting days. You got to wait.
You got to wait on
Him. For God's direction in your life.
That's right.
I'm so glad.
Yes, sir.
I'm so glad that we waited on God's direction.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's going to get a little hard, but if you wait on Him longer, He's going to make everything good for you.
Right.
He's going to make it right for you.
Thank God.
He's going to make it right for you.
Thank
I said something in Bible study one night, I believe it was. And it's concerning that God remembers your work that you've done for Him.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Anything that you do for God.
Yes.
Yes.
God remembers it.
Glory.
And what you do for God won't throw it in the lake. Forget what you do for Him, He'll reward you.
Yes, He will.
God hasn't forgotten about you.
No, God.
And the things that you have done for Him.
Thank you, God.
Do you really think God has forgotten all the miles that you traveled?
Lord,
Jesus.
God sees that. God knows that.
Yes.
And it looks like God is not going to come.
Yeah. My Lord.
But God comes just in the time.
Just in time.
Yes.
He's going to take care of you.
Yes.
Glory.
Yes, He is.
He's
going to
take care of you.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
All that money wasn't in vain.
Jesus.
Up and down the highway.
Glory.
do for the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Oh.
Yes. I wish I would have found out this years ago, bro.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. My life would have been much better off now, but I had to go through the chapel board.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Glory.
My Lord. I had to go through some stuff, some learning experiences.
Hallelujah.
So I can stand behind this roster.
Yes,
and tell y'all that every move you make is not from God.
Amen.
You got to consider your ways and make sure that God is leading and guiding you.
Amen.
Wherever you go in life, make sure that you take God with you. Make sure that you take God with you. And every move that you make, you consider. Talk to God about it.
Amen.
And let him lead you and guide you.
Amen.
Because where you go, it may get hard after you get there.
Amen.
But God's going to make it plain. You know what, Dick? And I'm about to close, Lord knows I'm trying to do this.
Thank you. That's all right, Pastor.
Abraham made a move that God didn't tell him to in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
God told him to get with around your kindreds.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I don't want nobody with you.
Uh-huh.
Get with around your kindreds. And he took Lot's nephew.
Uh-huh.
When he took Lot, that was one of the biggest mistakes he ever made.
Mm.
Because they began to fight.
Mm-hmm.
The land got too full.
Mm-hmm.
They had to separate. Mm-hmm. Lot chose the best part. Look at the move Lot made.
Mm-hmm.
He chose the best land.
Mm-hmm.
Abraham chose no dust.
Mm-hmm.
No water, nothing.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm. Lot chose the best.
Mm-hmm.
And he ended up in a bad place.
Yes,
he yes,
did.
Yes,
he did.
Yes,
he did. And guess who had to come get
him?
Glory to God.
That's right.
That's all right, Pastor.
Oh, Abraham had to go get his nephew.
That's right.
Yes, he did.
He showed it.
Had to go get him.
That's right.
He did. That's
awesome. Yes.
But on his way
out,
he met someone.
Oh, glad.
By the name of Melchizedek.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
sir.
With no beginning.
No beginning.
Go ahead.
Without a father.
Yes.
Yes. Without a mother. A picture of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He met him and he blessed him.
Yes.
That's all right, Pastor.
Watch the safe.
Mm-hmm.
Call Abraham to get blessed.
Uh-huh.
With your mistake.
Yes.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Let us stand. I'm going to leave you right there.
That's all right.
I'm going to leave you right there.
That's a little sermon.
Thank you.